going to be polishing. I don't know if you've seen my last video. If you didn't, then go and check it out. I'm going to be polishing other things that I cut in my last video. Some carboniferous coral. Or the slabs of the jasper agate that I cut. There's another few things in there. Some small agates. Some porphyry. Some quartz. Now what I'm going to do is I'll go through the first, say, 7 stages, and then I'll turn the camera back on in the last 3 or 4 stages and let yous follow the progress. Get back to you as soon as I've get through all these first stages. Welcome back, folks. It's been a few minutes for you, well, a couple of seconds for you, but a whole day for me. I couldn't finish all the stages yesterday. It was just getting too late. But I've been out here most of the day today and got through the majority of the stages on these pieces that I wanted to do. So I think there's 5 stages left. These should go pretty quick, so I'll film it all. I'll speed it up while I'm polishing. But this is just a wee sneak peek. The last grit I done, I think, was maybe, I don't know, 500 or something. That's quartz. Some galaxy stone. Yeah, the agate inside is actually quite nice. This, so I'm still not sure about this actually. I don't know what that is. It looks like agate at the bottom and then maybe some smoky quartz, some grey quartz at the top. That'll look nice when it's finished. This porphyry with agate inside, that'll look amazing as well. I love polishing this stuff. That should be really good when it's done. A wee thin slice of coral, carboniferous age coral. This has got some agate in it. I don't know where it is. Maybe some either mudstone or some really really porous basalt with some kind of agatized parts inside. It's really soft. The matrix soft in that one. And this, if you watch to the end, I'm going to tell you about this, the big part of the coral rock that I'm polishing. But if you watch to the end, I'll let you know what's happening with this. Some of that jasper agate that I found here in Scotland. It's really, really beautiful when it's polished. Still looking a wee bit faded. Looking a wee bit scratched up, but once I get through these 5 stages, it'll look beautiful. It'll look amazing. This is the best bit by far of the jasper agate bits that I've cut. Once it's finished, you'll be able to see the true beauty of it. It almost looks opalized in there. and the white part. It's beautiful. Keeping that as a personal bit. I'm going to send some of this rough agate to America for our Jake and Dan Graff, so they can polish them up. These rough pieces I'll keep for when I'm able to make jewellery, and I'll make some jewellery out of these polished pieces. It's really beautiful. It's lovely. And last is all these wee agates. If you've not seen any of these when I cut them, go to my last video and you'll see them. See me cutting them. Oh, you won't see me cutting them, sorry. You'll see the results of cutting. That's my favourite one of the small agates. It's almost see-through. It's got some eyes at the back. With a quartz centre. Right, so what I'm going to do is, I'm going to put my mask on. And then I'll probably do this stage without filming, and then I'll do the last four stages and I'll film it. I'll get back to you in a minute. Yeah, that's me on the last three stages. This pillow drill's actually heating up too much. Don't even know if it will last. These last three stages, I could start to smell the motor burning it. But we'll give it a bash and we'll see. Hope it doesn't burn out, because then I'm goosed. Do these last three stages and then take them in the house. I'll wash them, let them dry, and then I'll take some after pictures. And I'll show you them in more detail and tell you that about that fossil rock, what we're going to do with that. Thank you. Welcome back, folks. Here's the results. Firstly, I'll show you the wee tiny agates. There's a lovely wee waterline agate there. I'm not sure, but I think these are from Brazil, these agates. I've got loads of these as well, so I can do some more. This one's really cool. If you look at where the banding is, and that one. I think I've got three small bags of these, so cut some more soon. I like the quartz in that one. It's almost see-through as well. Last of the small agates. The polish is amazing. Now that I've got two new grits, 6,000 and 10,000 grit. This one actually came up a lot better than what I was expecting. It's extremely soft, the brown matrix, which I'm assuming is basalt. This tiny wee void in there with some crystals. Next, I'll show you these jasper agates. These are some of my favourite things to polish. I think they're beautiful. I found these in Scotland when I first started. Just one big rock. It looked like this on the outside, and I knew it was something special. I've actually got loads of these. I've kept some rough to send to Dan. Can't really see, but if you put a torch behind the white parts, it actually shows through. That's what it looked like. So if you see anything like that on the beach, pick it up, because it's that much beautiful inside. Beautiful. I really love that jasper agate. This one, personally, I'll be keeping for myself. I just love the shape. A small bit of calcite there. Some tiny wee crystals inside. My hands are actually killing me for doing this, but it was worth it. Next is the porphyry. I picked this up because of the agate parts on it. I was hoping that it would have some agate inside, and I wasn't disappointed. Absolutely beautiful. Contrast between the agatized parts and the feldspar crystals. It's amazing. Hopefully I can find more of that. Polish really well. I love porphyry. Next is a small galaxy stone. details in there. Some small agate parts. And also polished up good. Small quartz stone. Kinda strange. It's almost opaque in some parts, but then I don't know. I don't know what these bits are. Impurities. Cool. This one I really like. By far took the best polish out of all of them. I'm still not 100% sure what the grey part is. I'm assuming it's some smoky quartz and some agate up top here. Part of the coral rock that I cut off. Just a cut off piece. And last but not least, the big coral rock. This one will be a giveaway on our Facebook page, Fossils, Mineral and Archaeological Discussion on Facebook. If you'd like to win this and some other cool fossils or minerals from our moderators, then head over to the page and join us. But this will be one of the giveaways. This is why it took me so long, because this was just a rock, kind of roughly shaped the same way as now, and I've just smoothed it out. Took ages to get it looking like that, and even still it still has some cracks inside, but nevertheless it's beautiful. It's amazing to see all the detail up close. Anyway, that's it for today, but thanks for watching.